Good morning, my amazing Spartans. I hope you guys are having a fantastic Friday. Today, we're going to continue to work on our basketball skills. We're going to practice our ball handling and dribbling in place, and then we'll spend a little bit more time moving and dribbling. So let's review. Let's practice for about 5 minutes our ball handling skills. Remember, we can pass the ball back and forth from one hand to the other. Try to spread your hands out a little farther. Don't keep it too close. Make it a little difficult and move your hands farther apart from each other. We can move the ball around our body, just like this. Go in front and behind. You can go both directions. You can bend your knees and put the ball around your knees and around your legs. You can start off high and move down low. And come back up. We can try to move the ball between our legs. You can just put one leg up and put the ball under your leg, just like this. If you drop the ball, that's fine. Just pick it up and keep going. You can spread your legs apart and move the ball in between your legs. Or you can go around one leg at a time. And if you don't have a big ball, a bouncy ball, that's fine. You can use a tennis ball, just like this. You can do the same thing, toss it from one hand to the other. Move the ball around your body. Go in between your legs. All right, so let's pause the video and practice moving the ball around your body for 5 minutes. Ready? Set, go! Great job, my friends. You guys did fantastic. All right, next, we're gonna practice for a few minutes stationary dribbling, standing still and dribbling. Remember, we're gonna push down with our fingertips. We are not gonna slap at the ball like this. Push down with your fingertips. Either using your right hand or your left hand. We'll practice using both. Keep the ball at belt level. Try to keep the ball in front of your foot or on the outside of your foot, of whichever hand you're dribbling with. So I'm gonna dribble with my right hand. I'm gonna keep it outside and a little in front of my right foot. So you can practice dribbling, standing up nice and tall. One hand, then move to your other hand. When you feel comfortable dribbling with either hand, bend your knees, get down low, and dribble closer to your knee level. When you feel comfortable with one hand, move to the other. And last, we're gonna practice our crossover, bouncing the ball from one hand to the other, just like this. All right, again, if you don't have a large ball, that's okay. You can still use a tennis ball or a small ball. It's a little more difficult, but it can be done. Using right hand, your left hand, bending down, and crossing the ball over. Now, if you're having trouble using or dribbling with one hand, you can use both hands, either with the small ball like this, or with your large ball, or you can bounce and catch just like this. But let's try and use one hand. All right, friends, let's pause the video and practice stationary dribbling. 5 minutes. Ready, set, go. Great dribbling, my friends. You guys are doing amazing. I'm so proud of you. All right, now we're gonna practice moving and dribbling. So you're gonna need to set up a few cones. I have some empty water bottles set up down the room. You guys can use cones, empty water bottles, little buckets. You can just put socks on the ground, whatever you use as a marker going from one end to the other. All right, so we're gonna practice walking and dribbling take your time, make sure you have good control of the ball. Again, you're pushing down with your fingertips, keeping it at belt level. I'm gonna go around my cones, taking my time. All right, I'll show you guys one more time. Once you feel comfortable using your dominant hand, move to your other hand and dribble. Just like this. All right, keep the ball belt level, push down with your fingertips. Again, if you have to, you can use two hands like this. We're trying with one. But modify it any way you need to. So if you have to use two hands or just walk and bounce and catch like this, that'll work too. All right, when you're comfortable walking and dribbling using either hand, we're gonna practice jogging around the cones. So a slow run and having good control of the ball while we dribble and going around at a jogging pace. So let me show you what that'll look like. I'll move over to my other hand when I'm comfortable jogging with one hand. I'll practice jogging with the other. All right, friends, why don't we pause here? We'll practice walking around the cone, the bar end, and back. And then when you feel comfortable, jogging and dribbling. All right, friends, ready, set, go. Great job, everyone. You're doing such an amazing job dribbling. I'm so proud of all of you guys. All right, for our last activity, we're gonna practice walking in and out in between the cones in a snake or serpentine pattern. So I've set up a few more cones that I'm gonna walk in and out of. All right, so I'm gonna practice with one hand, going all the way through. Just like this. It's not easy, but I'm trying to maintain good control. Push down with your fingertips, keep it at belt level. All right, once you're comfortable doing it with your right hand or whatever your dominant hand is, practice again with your other hand. All right, just like this. Again, if you have to, you can use two hands or bounce and catch and walk. But the ultimate goal is to use one hand when you're dribbling. All right, when you're comfortable dribbling in and out of the cones with either hand, we can try jogging and dribbling. It's a little more difficult, but be patient. If you lose control of the ball, that's okay. Pick it up and keep trying. That's why we're practicing all these skills. All right, let me show you what it'll look like. Here we go. You're really good and you're really confident doing that with your dominant hand, you can practice with your other hand. It's gonna be pretty hard, but give it a try if you want. Just like this. Whew. All right, friends, pause the video again, practice dribbling in and out of all the cones and jogging when you feel comfortable walking and dribbling. All right. Ready, set, go! Great job, everyone. I am so proud of you guys. You guys did an amazing job dribbling today. We're all done with PE. Have a great, fantastic, amazing weekend. Be careful with the air quality. There's a lot of ash and soot. So stay healthy, remember, wash your hands, wear your mask when you go out. Parents, thank you so much, not only for having your child watch the video, but, you know, joining me on Back to School Night 2. You guys rock. You're amazing. You guys deserve all the credit in the world. So everyone at Stopper really appreciates you guys. All right. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you next week. Bye, everyone.